Hey, good morning, guys. How you guys doing? So we're back. Gonna be setting up today a 20 by 20 tent draping. So if you guys want to stick around and learn how to tent drape. We just got to the customer's house. Just waiting for them to open up the door. So we can get some cars moved out the driveway. We have some cars here in the driveway. We just got to get out. Good morning. How you doing?
Good.
Hey, Coco. Try calling her.
Oh, the dogs are barking.
Good morning, guys. For those that are joining, we're here in Long Beach, California. We just got here to our first stop of the day. We're setting up a 20 by 20 tent draping. So if you guys want to stick around and learn how to drape, stick around. Where's everyone from? Do me a favor, guys, if you guys can share this live. Hello, hello, how you doing? 109-226, how you doing? So we're here at the customer's house. We're just waiting for the customer to open up. Is anything, what do you think?
So
yeah, that's fine. If you want, you just pull up here. Make it. What do you think? I think it's fine, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, you can do that. Just,
So you can open the side gate?
You can open the side gate? Maybe when he comes, out,
or let him know.
Yeah, we'll let him know. Yeah, you know what? We'll just park right here on the. If you want to park right on the side, you can go ahead and then I'll just let him know that you're going to park on the side. Thank you, Carlos. Hey, how you guys doing? All right, for those that are just tuning in, we're here in Long Beach, California. About to set up tent draping. You guys want to stick around? In the car, you're fine. We're just, we're just gonna block the driver like that. Okay. It's fine. We have a nice little space to get through, so don't worry about it.
How
are you doing today?
I'm doing well. How are you?
Pretty good. Pretty good. You guys ready for tomorrow?
Think so.
All right. Perfect. Sounds good.
So I'm gonna kind of go all the way back here.
Okay. Perfect. Sounds good. We'll get situated. We're gonna unload and get situated. If we have any questions, we'll let you guys know. But we should be fine.
Okay. How long do you think this will take?
This will probably take about an hour and a half to two.
Okay.
Yeah. All right, guys. So let's go see where Carlos is at. Parking the vehicle. Just wanted to get everything situated with the customer. First thing I like doing, I like to communicate with the customer, see where the tent's gonna go, see how they want it, what side they want it. Carlos finished here. We're about to unload. Yeah, my crew here. I'm here with Carlos and Jocelyn. Say hi, guys.
Hello, guys.
Hello, hello. Good morning, guys. So we're here in Long Beach, California. We're about to set up a 2020 tent draping. If you guys want to stick around and enjoy the show. All right, so we're gonna unload real quick the stuff that we need. They fit me. They don't fit me that good. Yeah. All right, guys. For those of you joining in, welcome, welcome, everybody. We're here in Long Beach, California. We're about to do a 20 by 20 tent draping. It's going to look very beautiful with the colors that we got going on today. So if you guys want to stick around and enjoy the view, stick around, everyone. Do me a favor, guys. If you guys can share the live, that would be great. Share the live. If you think someone should learn draping, share the live with them. Okay?
You want to extend this? I'll help you extend it real quick, Cal?
We're just preparing. Let's go get the rest of the stuff we need from the truck. As usual, Carlos has it already. Carlos got the stuff that we need. So I need more poles. Let's get more poles. Show you the inside of the truck here. This here is going to be a Winnie the Pooh theme. Winnie the Pooh theme. They have some nice brown mahogany chairs there. Grass wall, baby table. And I think they have round tables here. Yes, they do. Round tables. And then their choice of tablecloths there. Over there, sorry. Carlos is over there getting us situated while I grab my poles. So in order for us to build the 20 by 20, we need 12 poles in total and 6 legs. Our 3 ways and 4 ways, which I'll show you guys in a bit. These are our 3 ways here. These always go at the end, and you'll see what I'm talking about in a second. And these are your 4 ways. These have 4 ways. One for the bottom, your sides, and your top. So I'll explain to these. So right now we're going to use our 3 ways here. Okay? Jocelyn, when you're done with it, can you bring me my hat, please? Thank you. So these are going to be your 3 ways here, guys. And these here are going to be our longs for 10 footers. What I like to do, I also like to color coordinate them. So I spray painted these blue. So me and my team, we know the longs are always blue. All right. If you guys are interested in doing this on hands, we do draping classes. So Carlos is going to help me. So what we're doing, we're just pretty much setting the frame of the tent first. Scoot this back a little bit more.
They wanted it more back there?
I was going to shoot over there. Lifesaver. Thank you, Jocelyn. Okay, Carlos, swing that over there for me. There you go, thank you. Get your better camera angle.
Yeah.
Okay, guys. So what I'm doing right now is what I just did, guys. These are all my three ways. Can you guys see the three ways there? So you have your three way there. You have one, two, and three over there. Now we're going to do our four ways. Our four ways always go in the middle here. Like this, one down and one to the other. Hello guys, those that are joining, how you guys doing? I know how to arm wrestle. You want to arm wrestle with me? So now four ways. Someone put hello all. Any of you know how to arm wrestle? This page is totally all about arm wrestling. So that's that. And now we're going to put our four way. Okay. One goes there. Another one's going to go here. you want to do. You want to make sure they're all nice and tight. You don't want none of this. If you guys live in high wind areas, you don't want none of these poles to fall on someone. Make sure they're nice and tight. Okay. So. Now we're going to put the last pole in. Three ways always go at the end, four ways always go in the middle. So, it's gonna go just like this. And again, make sure.
Yes.
Nice and tight. How's everybody doing? Do me a favor, guys. Those that are in here, you guys can tap the screen for me. Give me some hearts. Gives me energy.
Keeps you
going. Give me some hearts. Share the live for me. Nice and tight, guys. You see what I'm doing? Making sure it's nice and tight. Your bolts. Okay.
Two that we have to split in half, because the one in the middle, we don't have to split in half.
This is what your frame should look like. 20 by 20. And these are your three ways. You notice these are your three ways. So this is how they should look. One connected over there. Another one on this one. And another one on your top one. These are your three ways. Four ways are these over here. See how they have four ways? Can you guys see that? That way. 1, 2, 3, 4. You need 6 3-ways, 3 4-ways. For those of you that are just tuning in, I'm showing you guys a free mini, free balloon. Sorry, draping class. So Carlos is going to show you guys how to separate the draping here.
Very simple. So we grab our piece here, start, and you grab one edge of your draping. You gotta follow along and grab the other edge, or just find it here. What you wanna do is grab your two ends. You grab one end here, you grab the other end, and you wanna put them at the same level. In order for us to grab the center of the piece of draping. So once we have our two pieces here together, you want to run along with your other hand to get the center. And here's your center. You don't want to lose that.
think I'm gonna switch that one out.
Looks a little dirty.
No, it's just the
shade.
That's
how you get your sun.
The shade up here.
Switch out.
One more creamier.
As you guys can see, we all have them laid out on the floor.
Ready
to go. So since there's no tent light here, we will go straight to our balance. If there was a tent light, we would have to do our tent light first before we put our piece of balance. And the balance, our centerpiece and the balance up top, you do not have to separate. You would just have to separate our balances on the sides. Here, I'll come over here, bring you guys over here. Like I said, you don't have to separate this one to get the center. Just throw it along there. So you want to grab the two corners of your piece of draping at the end. Here's one corner and here's the other. So you grab the two corners, you put them together. And you run your hand along, and then you grab the other side of the piece of draping. You know, wanna kind of scrunch it up together. And this is how we're gonna tie. Well, we're gonna put our piece of balance on the top with a zip tie like this. So you're pretty much just from underneath. You're gonna throw a piece of draping over the top and zip tie. And now that we zip tied there, pretty much we just running along the piece of draping to the center where you meet with the four-way. Draping zip tight over there at that end. All you pretty much want to do is stretch over here with one end of seams. Then you grab your other end of the seams. This one over here, these two. You want to pull nice and tight. Then from the bottom, you just want to grab it with your hand like so to give it those nice curves and that nice decoration. Zip tie in the center, you always want to go across. So I'll show you guys right now. So that's our piece of balance right there. So you first start at one end, you zip tie to the three-way, then you go to the center, you zip tie across the four-way. This is what I mean by zip tying across. You want to zip tie across, not around. And then we'll do the other end.
Start going over.
Pretty much the same thing. You grab the two ends of your seams and pull. So put the two ends
How are you doing, guys?
Together and pull.
Carlos is showing you guys how to
come underneath,
do the balance.
To give it those nice balance.
You guys can do me a favor, but you guys can share the live for me. That'll be great. And get more people in here. If you guys think someone should learn draping, share the live, guys. Appreciate all the likes. We're at 1K. Thank you guys for the likes. You guys think we can get to 5K? Get me up to 5K, guys. Come on, let's go.
Just like that. All right. Now what we're going to do is I'm going to show you guys what Jocelyn here is doing. So she is just pinning three to four pins max, I would say. You would need. I'm going to start pinning over here, guys. This is what the pins look like. These are some heavy duty pins, guys. We do sell these on our website or in store. So check out the website. The link is in the bio, guys. Check it out. Appreciate the likes, guys. What size are the drapes? The drapes are, could be 12 to 13 yards. These are 12 yards. This tent here, it's going to be a 20 by 20, guys. For Marie, 20 by 20. Lindsay, the drapes are going to be 12 yards. Appreciate it, Lindsay. Thank you so much. A 20 by 20, yes. Jesus, thank you. 20 by 20. If you guys are not checking out Jesus, you guys do me a favor. You see Jesus, make sure you give that guy a follow, guys. He does some awesome work. Make sure you guys check out his page and follow Jesus Rodriguez. Appreciate it. You guys tuning in, this is a 20 by 20 tent draping. The customer wanted a baby blue balance with all ivory. It's gonna come out majestic once we're done with this. So again, guys, it's just the pinning process. Pin, pin, pin. Carlos did show you guys how to do the draping already. So that's what the balance should look like. He showed you how to separate it, and he showed you guys how to do the balance. And then all you're doing is just pinning your seams. You tuck in your seams so you don't see that. You tuck it in and pin. Say 3 to 4 safety pins. These are the safety pins. Some heavy duty safety pins, guys. Trust me, you guys do not want to use those cheap safety pins. They do not do the job. They'll start unpinning and you'll get complaints. Why is my draping unpinned? And it's because of your safety pins. Use quality safety pins. All right. Carlos, those are your pliers? Sorry. So now, guys, what we're going to do is have the center right here.
That's your center that Carlos showed you guys, and he's going to show you guys
how to throw it over.
How to throw over. So I'll let Carlos show you guys.
So you don't want to let go of the center.
Once you're done, you can start
the piece of draping. Always hold on to that. You can let go of the rest, then grab one side, and then what you're pretty much going to do is grab all the excess and throw over. And don't let go of the center. You always want to hold the center here. Here's my excess. I'm going to just throw over.
And you see how he's throwing over and he's still holding
the center. I never let go.
Never let go of your center. If not, one side's going to be bigger than the other.
Right. So, only 3 pieces per 10 feet up top. So, we're going to start with this one. Would be our first. And then we'll just continue throwing over just like that.
So, we need 3 pieces for every 10 feet. Okay, so Jocelyn is throwing over here, as you can see. As you can see, she's holding her center. She is not letting go of that center. If you let go of the center, it's just the indicator for her. You want to make sure it's nice and even. Alright? So,
this is my other piece.
This is the other piece.
Like Fabian was just explaining. Throw the excess. Hold the center. With your other hand, you want to grab the rest from one side. Never let go of the center. Always hold on to it. Now that I have the excess, I'm just going to throw it over. And here's my center. Spread it over here. And let's keep going.
What I'm doing now, I'm just pinning. Just want to scoot it back so you guys can maybe get an idea. Just pinning.
Separating.
And for those that are tuned in, if you guys are interested in actually doing a hands-on draping class, we do offer hands-on draping class. Just make sure to hit that follow button on the top and stay in the loop. Follow us on Instagram if you guys like. The link is in the bio. Has a link tree on there. There's stuff for you guys so you guys can see. We also do balloon classes. If you guys are interested, check the link out in the bio, and there's free tutorials on how to. So little tip for the day for you guys. Check it out. The link is in the bio, guys.
Okay. Sure. I'll try to beat, you know. Mm-hmm.
Pretty much you and Joss today, for now.
Mm-hmm.
You and Joss, for now.
Okay.
As I explained. So, what Carlos is going to be doing, guys. I'm not sure if you guys can see. One second.
Kind of hard to see.
Huh? Well, it's the glare on the camera. So, the glare, and it's just too sunny out here, guys. Let me see if I can put this up higher. Okay, so yeah. So what he's doing, he's folding over. He's gonna overlap his seams. So how he's overlapping there. Now what he's gonna do, he's gonna throw one over the other, just like that. And then he's going to grab his heavy duty pin and he's going to pin all three at the same time, which is 1, 2, and 3. Try pinning all of them so it's secure more better. So pretty much that's what he's going to do too. There's 1, 2, and 3. Same thing. So that's what he's going to be doing there. Jocelyn is doing the same thing. She's throwing over. You guys can see there. She's overlapping. She makes sure she's going to grab all three drapings. Heavy duty pin. And just pin it. Okay? Just like that. So that's what we're doing to all the drapings we just threw over, guys. Okay? You guys here for now. If you guys have any questions, let me know in the comments, guys. Talk to me. You guys can do me a favor and share the live. And you guys all do me a favor, all of you guys, start tapping on the screen for me. Just like this. You see the little heart there? Tap, 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 tap for me, guys. And try to get more people in here so we can all learn together, guys. What do you guys think? Tap, 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 tap the screen for me, guys. Appreciate it. Thank you, guys. So next thing. Yeah. Now what we're going to do is we're going to throw over, guys.
Have a lot. I mean, if we have more, then yeah.
Still good. Carlos, that one's still good. It's just, she didn't like how it looked, so I told her to swap it out. No biggie.
Guys, we're gonna throw over our tent here. How, who had that question, Christine? How are they overlapped? The center. The same thing, just here in the center. This is where you're talking about. We just overlap this way. You're gonna show. I'll show you right now. They're gonna. Are you still in here, Christine? So I can show you. If you are, give me a thumbs up. So I can show you if you are still in here, Christine. Appreciate all the likes, guys. Thank you. Appreciate everybody for joining. Thank you guys so much. Jesus, I appreciate all the likes. You guys all can do me a favor, double tap that screen. Jesus, thank you for the likes. Thank you. They wanted to see how you overlap, guys, so I'm going to show you guys. I'm going to show you how she does this. Are you in here, Christine? That was for you, Christine. Answer your question for you right now. Yeah, thumbs up. There you go. You're still in here. Okay, so see what she's doing? So she's overlapping that part. I think you're talking about this part, correct? On the with the four ways. So this is how she's going to do it. and this is in your center, guys. These are with the four ways. So it is a little tricky on here. I'll let her do it for you guys. Can you guys see okay there? I can barely see the screen because of the glare. It's pretty sunny out here today. It's bright, right? Can't even see the screen. So she's overlapping there. Mm-hmm. She's gonna pin that. Don't get nervous on me, Jocelyn. You've done this hundreds of times already. She's a little shy. She's doing a good job, right? Is she doing a good job, guys? You guys tell me if she's doing a good job. You can see it. Perfect. Thank you. So this is what she's doing. Look. So she's gonna overlap. You want me to explain or you explain?
You can explain.
I can explain. Okay, so what she's doing, she's just pretty much put them together here. You see how that is? And then she's just going to put a safety pin right there. She's going to put one on the top to secure it on the top. And then she's going to put another one on the bottom to secure that on the bottom. Just about maybe about a foot, maybe a couple inches. And then same thing we did on this side here, we're going to repeat on the other side. I'll show you guys. Same thing. 1 second, guys. Boom, 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 do a 360 with me. There you go. Not of me, with me. So, same thing. She's just pinning. Same thing she did on the opposite side, she's going to do on this side. That's pretty much how we do the center. And again, guys, make sure you got some quality safety pins. If not, we're going to have some unpinning. And it's not going to be a good day for you guys. So now, let's throw the tent roof over. I'll show you guys. Put it over here so you guys can see how me and Carlos will throw this roof over. Get you guys at a good angle here where you guys can see. Right there. Is that okay for you guys? It's kind of hard for me to see the screen, guys. I'm sorry. There it is.
Yeah.
Yes, it does. Thank you, Sandy. Did a great job. Yes, great job. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. She said thank you.
Thank you.
So, yeah. So, what it does, yeah, it kind of hides the poles in the center. And you'll see. You guys stick around. Stick around, Christine. You guys stick around. And I'll show you guys the steps. So, take advantage of this free mini draping class. All right, guys? Do me a favor, you guys. Tap the screen for me. Give me some hearts. Send some likes. And share this with someone that you think should learn, that wants to learn draping. Bring them over our way and hit that follow button. We're at 3,500 likes. Get me to about 20,000, guys. Come on.
20K. Let's go.
There's
bungees.
You guys see me? There you go.
Older guys, what I like to do, I like to start with the corners first with my bungees. When have you guys set up tents? Let me know in the comments, guys. I'm kind of interested. Are you guys familiar with setting up tents? Let me know. Which one of you guys set up tents and draping? Let me know if you guys set up. Or am I wasting my time showing you guys? I don't think so, right? Are you guys learning? Give me some thumbs up, everybody, if you guys are learning. Start with the corner. Come here on the bottom. Overlap.
over, pull this guy this way, over, just like that. Do the same thing on the other side. Two corners. And then we'll start with our tent.
Do you need more punches?
I like to do it. I like to flip this over so I can see where my little grommets are at, my little holes, where my bungees are going to be going in. And pretty much one, two. I'm going to do that on this side and on the other side.
Where are you guys watching from? Let me know, guys. What are you guys doing?
I'm getting bored, guys. Talk to me. I want to read some comments. Marie, good. I'm doing a good job. All right, you're learning. Do you do any decorations, Marie? Balloon decorations, draping, El Paso. At Texas, nice.
Texas.
I think Leslie's going out to Texas. I'm not sure what part of Texas she's going to. Not this month. I think next month she's going to be out in Texas doing a balloon class. So if anybody's interested in taking a balloon class in Texas, keep us on your favorites so you guys can see when's the next class. I meant to say, put your notifications on, guys. Put your notifications on, so
we'll be posting on Instagram our classes. Yeah.
Yeah.
And Carlos is doing the same thing. Finished over there.
All right, guys. Now what we're gonna do is let's break this tent up.
Now they're gonna.
And these here, guys, are your legs. These are always gonna be your legs, and these are 6 feet, 8 inches. I'm about 5'9", so you can see, go a little bit more up. So there it is. So 6 feet, boom, right there.
Yes. They will be putting the poles up.
Ready, Carlos?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3.
Carlos doing the same thing over there.
Are you guys paying attention? How many legs do I need for a 20 by 20? If anybody's sticking around that was with me earlier on in the class, I explained to you guys how many legs for a 20 by 20 do we need. Who can tell me in the comments, guys?
Pop quiz.
Who can tell me how many legs do I need for a 20 by 20?
Yep.
Lindsay, your answer is absolutely correct.
Good job.
Sandra, correct. Creations by Claudia, you are absolutely correct. Good job, guys. You guys are all paying attention.
Perfect.
Take notes, guys. I appreciate it if you guys take notes, because all this stuff is going to help all you guys out in the long run. So take some notes. Ready, guys? Mini online class for you guys, so whatever notes you guys can take, I recommend taking all the notes you guys can, soak it all in. So now that the tent's up,
the
bungees start on every single grommet. Follow me. Now I can take this off because we have shade now.
Finally.
Oh, it's hot.
It's hot.
And in Texas.
Oh, sorry.
What's the weather out there in Texas? What was her name? 1 second. Sandy's Creations. What's the weather in Texas?
We're complaining over there. Over
Christine,
here.
Christine, thank you guys. We're at 36K, guys.
Yeah.
Think we can get to 5K? Just tap that screen for me. I'm going to show you guys real quick how to put these on. Carlos is doing the same thing on the other side.
tight and secure.
One.
Two.
You can go three if you like. I like going two. One, two, this is three.
Real
more tight. Tighter, more secure. Just an extra step in process. I do two. Two of them is pretty secure. Now if your bungees are pretty loose, and then you know, like this one here is pretty loose, pretty simple for me to do a three, no problem. But if you have brand new jump, like this one here is like a nice brand new one. With two. One, two. Let me get some more bungees, guys. One second. I ran out of ammo. Just like that, I re-up. So same thing I'm doing here, same thing we're doing on the other side. In this case, the customer did not want a side wall, because it is hot right now. It's bipolar weather. So customer wanted some air to come in here.
Yeah.
And I did recommend that because the more walls you put,
the more heat it is inside.
The more heat it creates. And not only that, if we put a sidewall here, now your guest has to walk out that way. They can't exit this way. So take that in consideration. But as usual, I do whatever the customer wants me to do. They want sidewalls on every single... I'll do it. Like that, guys. Do that, and then I'll do this one here at the end. Okay. Wow, I can't work in that weather. See, Christine, good job. Saludos, chicos. Hola, saludos. Is it possible to do the TikTok? This here, these are your three ways. Is that what your question is? No, sorry, it doesn't get in my way. No, it doesn't. I'll show you guys. Stick around, Christine. I'll show you in a second. I'm not understanding your question, Joshua. Is it possible to do it the opposite way?
The opposite. I think he's talking about... No, he's not talking about the bungees. Is he talking about the bungees?
Are you talking about the bungees? Yeah, you can do it the opposite way. Are you talking about this way, maybe? Is this the way you're talking about?
Is that what you're referring?
Is this what you're referring to? If that works for you, Joshua, yeah, you can do it like that. But yeah, these won't get in our ways, Christine, when we do the draping, and I'll show you.
They won't even, yeah.
Yeah, but if you want to do it that way, Joshua, yeah, whatever works best for you. Yeah, okay, that's your question, yeah. Yeah, you can do that, but at the end of the day, Joshua, you're going to see, you won't be able to see these anyways. I'll show you. Stick around, Josh. I'll show you guys in a second.
You guys going to want to see the aftermath.
I'm going to show you guys. So now our next process, guys, we have our draping poles. Zip ties there. I do not have any zip ties. Carlos is ready.
I'm loaded.
You have my guy right here, Carlos. He's always, he stays ready, so he doesn't have to get ready. That's his motto.
Yep.
My motto is I can show you better than I can tell you.
Yep.
So let me show you guys. Come here. This one? Go ahead, buddy. Go ahead.
Uh-huh.
Want to explain, Carlos? Go ahead.
Yeah,
Carlos
is going to
be the leader because that's where we're starting from.
Okay. So pretty much, you always want to put this draping pole, the end of the draping pole, in the center of your four-way here. So you don't want it to be more over here or more over there. You want it right on the center. And when you put your zip tie, you don't want it here. You always want it closest to the four-way. Just like that. So remember, draping pole, always in the center. Zip tie, closest to your four-way. And then tight. You always want to tighten it real good. And then you could just push back your zip tie so they don't see that.
Yes.
Just like that. And you don't want it too much over here or over there, the zip tie. Always remember you want it right here, close to the four-way.
Now, what Carlos showed you over there, I'm going to show you guys over here. Pretty much try to put your zip tie as close as possible to the end here.
like Carlos said, you don't want to put it anywhere over here, because that will get in your way when you try to slide over your draping.
And you'll see the majority of the pole.
If I was to put it here, if I was to put my zip tie here, it's not gonna allow me to slide it all the way over. This is in the way. So I want it over. There. So I'm able to slide all the way. Alright? So we're gonna do the same thing on the opposite side. So same thing we did here, we're gonna do there.
Guys, and we're
going to
do the same
thing on the other side with our draping
Do you guys have any questions so far? Any questions?
Don't be shy, ladies. Don't be shy. Talk to me.
Christina is asking how much a minimum to charge a 20 by 20 tent with draping.
It depends. It depends in your area. It could all depend in your area, you know. But you can charge.
Depends.
Yeah, it actually depends on the area. Depends on the area, and it actually depends what the customer wants. Like, you know, they want extra walls. The customer wants to add a back wall there. It would be more. Something basic like this can run you close to maybe $1,000. Yeah.
Yes.
Tags, delivery, and all that good stuff.
Yep. Lizzie is asking, what kind of poles are those and what size?
These, we call them draping poles. You can find those at Home Depot, guys. You can find these at Home Depot. Those are going to be your draping poles, 1.5 inch EMT. You'll find those in the electrical department, Home Depot or Lowe's, either one of them. Mm. And they are 10 feet. Those are 10-foot poles.
10-foot poles, you guys.
So next thing, guys, what we're going to do is going to throw over.
Now we're going to be throwing over.
And just put it over here if you want to start.
I can't charge it because I'm going to take it.
Okay.
But, I don't want to move too much.
That's okay. 1 second, guys. Plug it in from the bottom there for me.
Where is it? Wait a minute. Does it?
Doesn't matter.
I think I used that. I used that. Is it charging?
One second, guys. My battery is about to die, so I'm just trying to put this on the charger. So Carlos is gonna show you guys. Jocelyn is gonna show you guys here how to throw over.
So the draping that we put out. The reason why we put the poles is so we could put it over, and that's how you get it to look nice. Now you put it over the pole, the last one.
So you slide that. You saw how the draping pole there in the middle. Yes, Joshua, they're all the same lengths. Check out if you guys are interested in purchasing any linen.
check out our website. We do ship out the linen. So if you guys are interested, there are 12 yards each panel. So each panel is 12 yards, guys. And it's good for your size tents, your 10s, 15s, and 20 widths. Okay, so Justin is just throwing over. Carlos already threw over on this side. So then we're going to show you, he's pinning over there, but we're going to show you the same thing. So pretty much it's the same concept, guys. So the same thing you guys are doing on this side here, you guys are literally going to repeat everything you guys did on that side on the other side, okay? So Carlos is going to, Carlos is getting a little head start. He's pinning there. Yeah, you can finish that over there.
Yeah,
finish that side. And then, if anything, Jocelyn is going to be the camera girl. And she's going to help me here so I can explain how to pin.
Okay.
Over here, Polly.
This is crazy.
We need our pins. Let's read some comments before. Hello, guys. Those that are tuning in, we're doing a mini live draping class. So tune on in. And this is, I was looking on that side. Carlos is doing this side here. And like I said, same thing he's doing on that side, we're going to repeat on the other side together. That is correct. That is correct, Christina. The pinning is so you don't see the pool. Okay, so I'm going to show you guys here how to pin.
1 second. It's hot out here.
No air, no nothing.
Okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to overlap so we don't see these seams. Overlap just like that. And this is, we're going to slide over. Slide over, and this is where I'm gonna pin up there, and then just bring this one and pin from the bottom. You guys see that? And that's how I should cover that one. Slide this over a little bit more, just like that. That's how that should look, to secure it from it sliding. Okay. And again, guys, just make sure to use heavy-duty safety pins. I recommend. If not, that's gonna unpin with the tension. Okay, so now we're gonna do the same thing on this side. Overlap just like that. Looks nice and pretty. And overlap this side just like that. Can you guys see that? Perfect. Now what we're gonna do is, can you show them the top, Joss?
You're going to want to look at the top.
Look at the top to see
Let me show you guys.
Yeah.
Look at the top.
So you guys can see what overlaps, which one's going to overlap over each other.
Yes.
See that?
Can you guys see? You guys want to make sure to see. Don't so just pin it. Make sure and look up.
Overlap.
Once.
Look up and it should look like that.
Oh, sorry. See how it looks all nice and pretty on the top? Because it's overlapping.
Okay. So we're going to do them. A lot of times it's loose on the top. It's kind of loose right here because it's, I haven't got to this one yet. So working on this one over here. So I like to hold it nice and tight there. I like to pin my fingers there. And I'm still not letting go. Don't ever let go. Just hold it nice and tight there. We're going to pin.
Pin.
Using my pin, and I'm still holding. Notice how I'm not letting go. If you let go, it's your drapes are going to be loose. So I'm pulling. Just pull. Just hand tight, not too tight. And then your drape on the bottom, you're going to overlap and pin. Okay? Overlap and pin. And pin. That's it. Overlap.
Yes,
pin. Yeah. And secure. And let go. You see the tension on this? It's pretty nice. You guys can't. I don't know if you guys can see, but it's pretty nice tension here. And if you use cheap safety pins, that's going to unpin.
Oh, snap.
Okay. Any questions so far? So it's the same thing. I'm going to go over here.
Overlapping.
And I'm going to continue.
Want
want you guys to see the overlap, and he's going to do the same thing here.
So I'm going to overlap that one. I'm going to overlap here. Same thing. I want to look up to see what's going to overlap, which one's going to overlap over each other.
You're going to want to, oh, what?
Okay. I'm going to pull, pinch, hold. I want to open my pen first.
Oh, he's got to get me ready.
Same thing. Hold there. Overlap. Secure. Okay. You're not going to see none of this because we're going to cover all of this. And Joshua, if you're still in here, remember the bungees? We're not going to see this because this is still going to get covered with your balance, which is your baby blue that's on the top. You see what Carlos is doing on this side?
Oh, there.
So what Carlos is doing is Carlos finished unpinning. So what I'm doing on the other side is same thing. So now Carlos is doing the balance there. And he's getting a head start on this side. But same thing you do on this side, we're going to do on the opposite side. So I'm going to show you guys on this side. Okay? So come with me. And I'll show you guys. You guys can see how that draping is coming out. So this is very important here, guys. If you guys want to take notes of your center. So we're going to overlap.
Overlap. It's a different part. You don't
want to. So I like to overlap. Pull. Overlap, pull these two together. You're going to pin as high as you can on these. One, two, secure. Okay. Now I'm going to cover the poles, and that was going to answer Christine's question. Remember, Christine? So this is, I'm going to show you so you can see the poles now. First, you see them. Now you don't. So now, same thing. You're going to overlap, and pin from the bottom.
And you guys see that the pull is gone.
And you're still not going to see it because your balance is going to cover it. Okay? Your balance would cover all this here.
So if you guys look up. Oh,
oops, sorry.
If you guys look up, there is no pull. Just like that.
So now I'm going to finish off, guys. Same thing. Same thing I did over there in the beginning. Let me see. Can I see that correctly? Yeah. So the same thing I did. Over there. I'm going to do. So this 10 feet, it's done. So remember, it's 10. And then you have your 20. So all I have to do is this side now. I already did the middle. So now, keep going.
Keep going. Oh.
I'm going to throw over this one. Okay. So now what we want to do, we want to pin it here. Are you guys following the overlapping process?
Any questions
for those
so far?
That are tuning in, we are doing a free mini draping class. So, can you guys see how I'm overlapping these? Look at this. You see the seams here? Not sure if you can see the seams. There you go. You see the seams? You don't want to see those. So let's overlap them so you don't see them there.
Okay.
And then you're going to overlap the other one. Over here, and overlap like this. Just like that. And just like that. Okay.
And you're going to want to look up. Like what he's doing.
answer or call.
So it's going to pinch. Pin. Make sure you hold it. Don't let go. And
grab from the bottom.
Grab from the bottom. And secure.
Do the other one, then I'll fix that one.
Any questions so far? Great tip on overlapping. Yes.
And if you guys are interested in taking our own hands draping class, which I highly recommend.
Yes.
You guys can actually be doing this, actually hands-on, pinning, and getting the feel, because me, I'm not a visual person. I'm a hands-on person. I have to actually feel and do it. I don't learn by just looking. Some people are a visual person. Are you a visual person, Justin, or hands-on?
Hands-on.
For sure.
It's got to be hands-on.
For sure. So I'm going to overlap. And overlap. Once you have this pinning down, then it should be easy from there. Overlap, overlap. Same thing, you can do overlap here, overlap. You're going to do that to every single one of them and pin. So overlap, overlap. Pull.
Look up.
Look up. This one's going to go underneath that one. Pull, pull, pull. Hold.
See how you guys, he's holding there, but still pinching from the top.
Pinch from the top. You want to pin.
Once you got the top, you're going to want to put the bottom.
Secure. That's it. And all this here is going to be covered with your balance. Okay, I have one more piece to go and I'm done. And we'll show you guys the next process. So now, what we're going to do is, same thing. Same thing I did on that opposite end. I'm going to overlap to hide the seams. Very important to hide those seams. You overlap. You lift. Pull. So how I pulled all of that draping. If I don't pull all that, it's gonna it's gonna look ugly from the top. So pull. Pin. See where I pin? I'm still pulling down. Never let go. Pin. Secure. I'm gonna cover that border. There you go. See how I cover that pole? Now you can't see it. And that's how that should look there. Okay. So this is your pinning. This is all your pinning part, what we just did.
All that. Don't worry, you guys. The pull will be hidden with the balance. Yeah. We got Carlos. And you guys see the top? This is how your top's supposed to look like. That's why we pull. Hide the seams so you don't see no seams, no nothing. All pretty and everything.
So now the next step, guys, is gonna be how to put how to put your balance. Okay? So I'm gonna show you guys on my side. So Carlos is done on this side, you see her?
How beautiful. It's really nice.
So this is how it looks. So he's done on this side. Okay, so this side is going to look exactly the same on the opposite. The customer didn't want any side walls, so she wanted it all open. See, she wants it open there.
This is a 20 by 20 with no tent, no end wall, and no side wall.
And see, these, I still need to fix my drapes there. What I'm going to do, I'm going to fix them just like Carlos did here. You see how he made them look all nice and beautiful there? So there. And there. So same thing Carlos did on this side, I'm gonna do on this side. You see how this side is not done at all. But I'll show you guys in a second. And then my drapes are always, you gotta have your draping always ready.
Should be. Yeah.
And same thing, guys. Earlier Carlos showed you guys how to separate your draping.
Well, you guys are gonna do exactly the same thing for your ballots. Okay? So once you do that, you guys, for those that are just tuning in, I'm gonna show you guys because maybe you guys weren't here in the morning. So for those that are tuning in, I'm gonna show you guys how we separate the draping. So let's just say we got this out. So what I wanna do, I wanna make sure I get both my ends. You see how this end here is bigger than this one? That's telling me that. Yeah. See? So I'm gonna make sure I grab both ends. So I have one end here and I have my other end here. So both ends, like putting them together so they're nice and even. And then I just lift. And this is going to be my center. You guys see that? Let me know if you guys see that. If you guys want me to repeat it one more time. Laura, you can purchase the drapes on our website. The link is in the bio. Check us out. Okay. Christina, yes. So the white, well, it depends. So this is actually ivory. It looks white, but it's actually ivory with baby blue. So it's just all your, up to what the customer wants. But in this case, you chose all ivory with your baby blue balance. Appreciate it. Thank you, guys. We're at 73,000, guys. You think we can get to 10K? If you guys, those that are in the live, do me a favor and tap that screen for me. You see the likes? Give me some hearts. There you go. I appreciate all the likes, guys. Thank you. So, if you guys need me to repeat it one more time for you guys, you guys got it. Let me know before I start the next process. Okay?
Let us know if you have any questions.
Now I got my center. The linens are all the same size, yes, 12 yards. Okay, so now that I have my center, I'm going to open it. I'm going to put these together here. Flip it down here. And like I said, guys, it's always better. It's always better to take the class and do it on hands-on. So I'm going to swish it just like this. So that's that. I'm going to swish it just like this. Oop, this way. Sorry, guys. So that's that. And I swish it just like this.
And that's how we get the balance looking good.
And just like that. So I'm tucking in my seams there. So I don't see my seams. So I'm tucking them in there. And now I like to stay ready. Tie my zip tie. Put it in my center. Now we can go connect it over to the draping pool. Follow me, guys. Let's go. So where's everybody watching from? We have 48 people in here now, guys. In the comments. Laura, yes, repeat, please. Repeat, repeat. Okay, I'll repeat for you guys. Okay. Yes. Yes, we do. We cut all the zip ties, and I'll show you guys on my side. Carlos is over there working on his side. He's going to start cutting right now. Hemet, California. We're also from Los Angeles. Christina, you come check us out. Christina, have you checked out our balloon store, Christina? Come on down. Mention this post and I'll give you 10% off. If you guys don't know where we're located, the link is in the bio. We are located in 10820 Hawthorne Boulevard, Inglewood, California. Wilmington, Cali. Okay.
Yeah.
We're here. We're located in Inglewood, California, guys. Chi-Town, LA. All right. I was just in LA yesterday buying material. Oh, okay, nice. You went last week for the first time. Okay, cool. How'd you like it, Christina? Was it nice? Okay, I'm going to repeat for those that wanted me to repeat again. I didn't forget about you guys. Sorry, I was just reading the comments, just trying to catch up with all the comments. Really close to you guys. Appreciate it. Thank you, Maria. Maywood, California. Okay, you're right down from us. We're in Inglewood, California. South Texas. All right, Teresa. I'm going to show you guys one more time how to split the draping, okay, guys? So, same thing. I want to split it. I want to find my both ends again, okay? So, make sure you have one here, and two there. You see your two ends. Two ends. You're going to put them together. Just like that. So they're nice and even. Nice and even. Put them together. And then you just go all the way down until you find your center. Okay, I'm going to drop it. And this is my center there. Okay? So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to open this.
It's still holding on to the center.
Okay? Still holding on to the center. Overlap. Grab it from the bottom. You're never letting go of your center. Okay? You're going to tuck, 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 tuck. Seams in the middle. Just like that. Okay? You can grab your zip tie. And put it in just like that. Now we're going to go in the middle here. So this is the technical part, guys. Pay attention. Take notes. Okay, guys? So what we're going to do is zip tie. If you put your zip tie here, if you put your zip tie there, you want to start the swoosh that way. Okay? If you put the zip tie here, you're going to start this way. Okay? I'm going to put it here. Okay? Put your zip tie there. You notice how I put it right on this side, so I'm going to pull this way, okay? If I pull this way, it's going to slide right off, so that's why I want to slide that way. So make sure this is nice and tight. I'm just going to tuck this guy in there, just like that, and you won't be able to see it. You can cut it. I just like to tuck it in there, okay? But you don't see it anyways, okay? So now I'm going to start my draping that way. Now you want to open it and make sure you grab the drapings correctly. Okay, once I have it, notice how my seams are on my top. You see that? What I'm going to do is I'm going to tuck in those seams. I'm just going to flip it over. Like that.
Folding over, okay. So you don't see the seams.
So you don't see the seams there. You see how you don't see the seams anymore? Okay. And your main job is you want to hide this pull here, so you're going to make sure it's from the top and pull. You're always pulling. Remember, pulling is a very key in draping. That tension, holding that tension and pulling, because if you let go, it's going to, see how it's all loose now? So the main thing, always when you're doing the pinning on the top, a key factor for draping is always holding nice tension. If you let go some tension, it's just gonna slack. Okay, cool. Don't let go. Little tip for the day for you guys.
Lift up real quick.
Go ahead, Carlos. Okay, I want my zip tie ready. Carlos is over there putting the weights on, getting a head start.
Complete.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so now I'm gonna hide. I'm gonna show you guys one more time. Okay, so you wanna pull. Overlap. Okay, like that. Now we're gonna come here. Pull. Same thing. How Carlos showed you how to do the draping on the top. Same thing we're going to do on the bottom.
And that's how you get it to look like that.
It should look like that. And you're going to zip tie. You're going to zip tie here.
like to hold it. I don't like to let go. And
you can see he hasn't tightened it yet,
nice
but he's
tight.
Trying
to. You see
to
how I'm holding this? I'm not letting go because if I let go, I'm gonna mess up my nice drape in there.
We don't want the pole to show, so he's gonna hold it
so
tight.
I'm hold it nice and tight and zip tie while I'm doing it. Okay. And that's what it should look
and
like.
That's how you get the balance to look like this. You guys have any questions so far?
Okay.
We got one more balance to do.
So I just need to do the other side and then I'm all done. And then I'll show you guys the next step. Any questions, guys? No problem. Thank you for tuning in. What's your name?
Terry?
Terry Rowe. Thank you for tuning in. Terry. Make sure you hit that follow, guys. Thank you, guys. We're at 11K now. You think we can get up to 20K by the time we finish? Keep smashing them likes, guys. Appreciate it. Smash them likes.
How many yards are the balance?
The balance? Do you guys remember anybody in the comment section? Anybody in the comment section want to answer that? See who was listening. How do I do with the 20 by 30? A little different, more. But to answer your question, they're 12 yards.
12,
yes,
12 yards.
Yards.
Correct.
Thank you.
Correct.
Thank you, Luis. Miguel.
12 yards.
13 yards. You could do 13 yards if you want a little bit bigger, but just stick to the 12 yards. 12 yards, everybody. Thank you guys for paying attention.
Yes, correct, you guys. 12 yards. Balance will be 12 yards. The ivy draping, 12 yards. All the draping, 12
yards.
Let's
see those OGs that were in here from the beginning. I'm seeing, okay, you guys are paying attention.
Yeah.
For a 20 by 20, how many longs do we need? The longs, I refer to the 10 footers. How many longs do we need for a 20 by 20? Does anybody remember that? You guys already answered my question earlier. How many legs we needed? We needed 6 legs. How many longs do we need for a 20 by 20? Okay. No, 6 were for the legs, guys. Remember, 6 were for the legs. We need 12 longs. 12, 10 foot. There you go. Carla. Good job, Carla. 12. We need 12. Okay, guys? I'm going to show you guys how to do this. This one here. This is the last final balance, guys. As you guys can see, we did that balance over there. Okay?
Really pretty.
Now this one over here. How the balance looks, guys. Are you guys approving the balance or I'll redo it? If you guys want me to take it down, I'll redo them. Okay, so that's this side over there. 1, 2, 3. You guys want me to redo them or leave them?
How's it looking, you guys? How's it looking?
If you guys were the customers, would you guys tell me to remove it or leave it? Let me know in the comments, guys. Leave it or remove it?
Leave it or remove it.
How's it looking, guys? Do you guys tell me?
Let us know.
Let us know in the comment section, guys. So I'm going to show you guys here how to do the balance. So you guys remember? So it should look like that over there. You see how it looks at the end over there? You see your seams on the top? We want to cover these seams. Remember how we're going to cover them? We're going to pull. I like to pull nice and tight. And just fold a little bit there. You don't want to fold too much. Just fold a little bit just so you can cover the seams. Now you see them. Now you're done.
No seams.
All right. Come over here with me, guys. I'm going to show you guys real quick. Again, you see how it's just my habit of me not letting go. I always keep tension. It's just a habit I have. So, you notice how I'm still holding tension here. So, I'm going to come all the way over here because this is where it's like a little guy light for me. This is where my zip tie goes. So, I like holding it where my zip tie goes. That's just how I do it. You guys can do it however it works for you guys. I like pulling it here and I like holding it here where I'm pulling because that's where my zip tie is going to go. I don't like holding it from over here and pulling it because nothing's going there. So I like to, again, overlap your seams. I like to pull. This is where my zip tie is going to go. So I want to hold it there. Little tip for the day for you guys.
Yes.
Okay. And now let me go over my hook over there. Perfect. See that, guys?
No pull, no
now,
nothing.
I'm gonna swish it from the bottom. That's what I call it. A little swish. A little swish.
That's how he gets the balance to look like that, you guys.
I'm gonna come over here.
He's not letting go.
I'm still looking. See your balance, how it looks, guys. Look how the balance, how it looks. Still not letting go. And come here. And I'm going to put it here. Okay. I'm going to put it here. And now, notice how I'm still holding tension there. Okay, guys? Notice how I'm still holding tension there. And now, you zip tie it to your draping pole. And just like that, guys, you have yourself your balance there. Okay, guys?
You got you.
So now, next step. Let me see if any questions, concerns. It's a valance, balance, valance. There's a sash. Have you heard of a sash, Angel? A balance, a valance. We call it a balance, but it is a valance. You are absolutely correct. It's like the balance of your tarp here. A balance, whatever works best for you. You can call it whatever you want. But they call it a sash as well. Some people call it a sash, balance, whatever term that you want to give it. We call it a balance. You know, it's nice and balanced, you know? Okay, I'm going to show you guys the next step. Where do you guys purchase the panels? You guys can purchase it on our website, guys. Check out the website. The link is in the bio. The trim, there you go, Carla. A trim, whatever works best for you guys. Whatever you guys want to name it. You guys want to name it? Whatever you guys want to name it. A sheet?
If you're setting up the tent, you name it what you want.
Whatever you want to name it. What are the longs? The longs are, I like I said, that's what we name it. Our longs are our 10 footers. When you saw me, for those that saw me building the tent, those are all my long poles. And what I like to do is I spray paint them a color. So I can just tell the guys, hey, go get me a blue pole. They know it's a longs. You know, your legs, we spray paint them, green? Mm-hmm. Go get me a green pole. We know those are legs. But if you have new people on the team and they don't know the different sizes of your poles, little tip, spray paint them. So yeah, Nancy, we are setting up today. We are doing a 20 by 20. We're here in Long Beach, California, setting up a 20 by 20 here. This is all ivory with a baby blue valance. Sounds better, right?
Sounds okay.
Okay. All right, so now my next step, I'm going to show you guys here. So what we're going to do is we're going to mimic what Carlos did on this side. You want to see if Carlos needs any help?
Yeah.
I'll just set this here. Okay, guys, so I'm going to set this down for you. I'm going to show you guys what I'm doing here. You guys see me from there? I'm going to be working here. Okay. So what I like to do is pull here, over that there. Like a little swoosh there, you see that? I'm gonna zip tie that one here. Like that. That should look like that. You see that? So I like to do the ends first. Like that, you guys are just like a little swish
try to give it that form. Can you guys see that okay? That's how your middle should look there. And then I'm gonna do this one here. For those of you tuning in, do you zip tie? Do you cover the zip ties? We just snip it. You can put something over to cover it if you like. Yes, we do set up the day before, Christina, before the event. It's always good to set up on a Friday and Saturday. We're coming back tomorrow. So if you guys want to put your notifications on, when we come back on live tomorrow, we are dropping off the balloon garland. So if you guys want to stick around to see how we set up the balloon garland, we are doing that tomorrow. Okay? Yes, Jess, all the drapes are the same size. Okay, so I'm going to finish over here and show you guys how I tie the drapes together. Let me do you guys this way. Jess. No matter what type of tent it is, that is absolutely correct. So if you go on our website, there's actually a better description on there. But you're also, if you go on our website, just look up draping on the search bar and then it should pop up. I left the description on there for the drape. I think it cover the 12 yards. It's going to cover. It's up to your 10, 15s, and 20 widths. So you should be good with 12 yards. Okay. Let me show you guys how I do this one here.
So what I do, I overlap it. So just like that. Here. Grab the middle. Work my way down.
Zip tie. I think that looks nice right there. Right? Okay. What I'm gonna do is zip tie the bottom there. Thank you.
pretty much covering your pull and covering your weight.
Here, I'm done over. I'm done there, guys. How's it looking, guys? Okay. So now I'm got my last drape over there. You see how that one's hanging there? I'm gonna go fix it now. Sorry guys, let me read some comments. Yeah, next time I'm out draping Jess, I'll show you guys. For a 20 by 20 tent, would the valance be 18 yards? No, it's just 12 yards. Always 12 yards. Okay, let me come over here and just put the weight on that one.
Want to fold this up with before you go over there, Carlos?
Yeah, that's what I was gonna.
Yeah. Just so I can show everyone the end results. This here, guys, this stays like this for now.
So we have Carlos over here. Picking up, we like to put something on the floor so your draping doesn't get dirty when you're, but in this case, we have nice clean grass, so we don't have to worry about your draping getting dirty. We're just gonna fold that up, wrap it up. I'm gonna show you guys how the draping looks. So, oh, I need to fix that, right? You guys see something there? Let me fix that.
Look at
Here so I can give me some slack for my balance there. Now I can put it back. I didn't put it back. I was supposed to.
Is there on the floor?
Pretty much so your roof is not flapping.
Just for the floor, you know?
You took all the balances, right? All the zip ties? Lunges.
Got all that out of the way. And you do the same thing on this side. You see this? I'm gonna put another one here so it's not flappy. I'll steal one. Or you have one?
I don't have one. You want me to bring one?
Yeah, you can. You wanna fold this first though? And take it? Okay.
She needed it right now.
So we're all done here, guys. You guys can see that. Right here for you guys. You guys can take a look of what we did. Okay.
I'm gonna leave the shrink wrap on here for tomorrow.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, just for now. We're not gonna. Yeah, we're gonna have to move it tomorrow when we come set up the balloons. So we can leave that for now.
You can leave that one there for now. No? Yeah, we'll slap it. Or you wanna? You can slap it on there. Go ahead. Yeah, and I'll move it. I'll move it tomorrow. Yeah, it's like that grass wall. With our baby table, so we're gonna come back tomorrow, guys. And if you guys wanna follow the live tomorrow, yeah, it's holding up pretty good, right? You see how the wind's blowing? holding them good. So tomorrow, guys, if you guys want to stick around, we're going to come back tomorrow and put the balloons garlands. So hope you guys enjoy today's mini class. We have our tables and chairs over there ready. Carlos finished unloading. All right, guys. You guys can do me a follow.
So we need a food stand we still got to put up.
Yeah. We have a nice little Winnie the Pooh sign. I'll show you guys how to set all this stuff up tomorrow. We have an old baby sign right here. You guys see the old baby sign? And we'll leave all this here so it doesn't break. We'll leave this here for the customer. The old baby sign. So if you guys tune in tomorrow, we're gonna finish. So how does it look, guys? How does it come out? Tell me, how does it come out, guys? Hello, Haley. So we just finished setting up a 20 by 20 tent draping. And we're all done. We are going to come back tomorrow to set up the balloons. The balloons are going to go back there. So you guys stick around and tune in tomorrow. All right, guys, I got to go. Appreciate all you guys tuning in. Want to grab my glasses and hat there, Carlos? I'll give you guys a little view of how it looks. Get some quick signatures. You want to knock on the door, Carlos? There? Get some quick signatures. Want to take this with you, Carlos? I think I saw that. Yes, sir.
Looks
not. Nah. All right, guys, put my hat back on because it's pretty warm over here right now. So we're heading out, guys. Carlos just needs to get the contract signed. Do me a favor, Carlos. Ask her what time her event starts tomorrow. Oh, let me close this gate for the customer. Did you guys enjoy today's little mini class? I got this, Carlos.
Got it?
Yeah. Carlos is just gonna get some quick signatures. Hey, Carlos, was that a stamped off already? One second, guys. One second. No, it's good.
Yeah.
We'll be back tomorrow. Should be fine though, Carlos. I think it is. I saw it is. It's paid off. Let me just put this ramp up real quick and I'll get back to you guys. One second. Appreciate you guys still tuning in. We just finished setting up here in Long Beach, California. We finished setting up a 20 by 20 tent draping, guys. We're all done. We're just getting the final signatures. If you guys want to stick around for the ride home, we're going to head back to the shop real quick and do some cleaning over there. We need to start preparing. But if you guys want to stick around, enjoy us for the ride. Yes, I recommend it, Christina. I recommend the hands-on class if you guys are all interested I recommend it. Can't get better than hands-on. That's pretty much the best way you'll probably learn doing it hands-on. No problem, Christina. Thank you for tuning in. Yes, Anita, you missed it. Where were you? You missed it. But you can always sign up for another hands-on class. I recommend sign up for the hands-on class. Emily, you missed it. I'm sorry you missed it. We're all done, guys. Appreciate it. If you guys want to stick around and enjoy the view home, or should I end the live? If you guys want to stick around, want me to continue live, or should I end it? For those that want to stick around, how many thumbs up? Should I stick around? You guys want to enjoy the ride home? On the live, can you go on the live?
Mm-hmm.
Just want to see what it looks like.
Literally on my search. Where's the keys?
What'd she say, Carlos? Her event starts at 11 a.m.
Oh, that's right.
So I told her you guys will be here from 9 to 10. What'd she say, Carlos?
What's up
with you, my boy?
Let's go.
What's going on?
Not much, waiting for you. All good?
Yeah.
Let's go. You have my pen? I'll let you borrow my pen or you grab it?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. You're all good.
There you go. You gotta get the contract signed, my guy?
Yeah, my pen. I gave you my, I let you borrow my pen to get the contract signed.
Okay.
Can't lose my, our new Majestic pens, guys.
The keys are back there, huh? I bet.
The... These are the new pens. Let's check them out. Pretty cool pens.
More pens.
And we got some new pens. So if you guys, order online, we'll send you guys one of our newer pens. How do I flip this camera over so it's not? Thank you very much for your time. No problem. Thank you. Thank you guys for tuning in. Thank you, Carla. Thank you for tuning in, guys. All I ask you guys, if you guys just share the live and send some hearts my way, then I'll be good. Appreciate it. Thank you, guys. Appreciate the roses, guys. Not sure who sent the roses. Thank you so much. Christina, thank you for sending those roses. Appreciate it. Christina with the roses. Thank you, Christina. Can't pronounce your name. I can pronounce your last name, Lee. Lee with the roses. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Appreciate it. Appreciate it. Thank you guys for all the likes. All right, guys. So I'm gonna. I don't know how to turn this. Don't know how to turn this over. One second, guys. How can I flip the screen over? One second. Jocelyn, you want to help me out here? How can I? The screen. Can you or can you not? How can I flip the screen?
Oh, flip camera.
I'm tech savvy.
Oh, you guys can't see nothing. Hold on 1 second, guys. There you go. So, how'd you do that again?
Oh, you go on enhance?
Enhance, gotcha. That's all I needed. Thank you so much. All right, guys. You guys want to enjoy the car ride home? Let's go. Appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Enjoy the ride home, guys. You guys want to enjoy the ride home? Let's go. You got 30 minute drive. Not that bad. Put some music on.
Quiero comer, di qué vas a hacer. Así que come un dembow que se no respeta. Tengo para ti la combi completa. Que no duró mucho soltera. Aprovechando.
Come on, Triggs. Appreciate it, man. Thank you. Shout out. I see your profile picture there, man. You like fishes, dude? What you got there? Some clownfish?
Yeah, that's a clownfish.
Nice. Nemo.
Nemo?
Clownfish. Appreciate all the likes, guys. Thank you. Thank you for that. It's a girl, picture of a girl, a little girl. Thank you for the likes. Thank you for all the likes. 16K, guys. You think we can get to 20K? Let's vote. 20K, guys. Let's go. Tap that screen for me, guys. Thank you, guys, for all the roses. Appreciate it. Thank you, guys. Let me see here. Let me read some comments here. Any questions, guys? You guys have any questions for me? Talk to me. You got 30 minutes, guys. Talk to me. Thank you, Sandy, for the likes. Thank you so much. That noise you guys hear, guys? Tick, tick, bomb. The bomb. Not sure. I don't dance at boogie.
Just let it be. Why don't you be you? And now we need everything that's broken.
Sorry, guys, I don't know how to sing. It's like a song.
Why don't you be you?
There's a story behind this song. First time I heard this song.
And now we need.
Kind of hit different. Reality.
For it.
coat across the floor. She's cheating cards and slamming doors at you.
Sanchez, as of now, we don't have a next draping class, but stay tuned. It's coming up pretty soon. If you follow us on social media, TikTok or Instagram, Leslie, she stays pretty, keeps you guys well informed, so stay on the lookout. Leslie will be posting our next class. Leslie's at home right now, guys. If you guys are wondering where Leslie's at, she's at work right now, guys. She's setting up the balloons, getting ready, all the balloons ready for tomorrow. If you guys want to join us, we're going to come back tomorrow to set up the balloons. But she's at work making all the balloons. You guys stick around. We'll show you guys. Hopefully she's still doing the balloons when we get there. So yeah, Sanchez, just stick around. You know, follow us. Can you follow us on social media? On Instagram? Jesus, you're back. Hold on, Jesus, what's your days up to, man? What you doing today? No balloon shopping today, Jesus? I invited him to join the live. He won't join me though. Join the life, Jesus, don't be scared. You guys are not following, check out Jesus. Guys, check out his page. He does some awesome balloon work. Jesus is a regular for us. He comes in all the time to shop and to get his balloons. Check out his work. Just a little camera shy sometimes. Thank you, Jesus, for the likes, man. I appreciate it. Thank you so much. Thank you, Jesus, for the likes. Appreciate it, boss. Thank you so much.
K-Day, hip-hop back in the day, blazing it.
Ready, mate?
I'm still getting.
First time I heard
it. Me, young, me, on the west side, highway, doing what we like to do. Eyes behind shades, this neck was the reason all of my dates been blind dates. But today, I got my therapist girl with me. I'm mashing the gas, she's grabbing the wheel. It's trippy how hard she rides with me. The new Bobby and Whitney, only time we don't speak is doing sex in the city. She gets carried fever, but soon as the show's over, she's right back to being my soldier. Cause mommy's a rider, and I'm a roller. Put us together, how they gon' stop both us? Whatever she lacks, I'm right over her shoulder. When I'm on track, mommy is keeping me focused. So blessed, life will sound like it's supposed to be. The old green, Bonnie and Clyde, open me, pop. Y ahora quiero perreo toda la noche en la pared. No sé.
A mí me deja libre, no te ve límite. Déjame hacerte lo que me dijiste.
Ah. Un 30.
Imposible ignorarte, el sol al lado tuyo no es tan brillante. Yo soy tu.
La noche entera. La noche, bonita, rock.
¡Vamos! La vida se queda. Y este es el sabor, loco. Ay.
Hoy me di cuenta que te amé, que sin sentido te perdí. Por un idiota me puse, y ahora me toca a mí sufrir. Hoy me di cuenta de mi error, y me hago caso.
De acuerdo.
For an extra 25.
Question.
So why am I jamming
the bat?
No guessing. Stay your brothers.
A bit here.
Accident the
yeah, which is more.
After the war fight.
Vender de alguien más. Estás perdiendo.
Me forever. Oh, oh, oh. Or is it just the.
So 3-5 kid, well, back in the day, you're enjoying the busy ride with your girl Stacey. It's Friday and it's payday, so it's a great Friday. And of course, all weekend long, we're hooking you up with a pair of tickets to check out Usher. It's his Vegas residency. All you gotta do, KD Nation, we're gonna make it super simple for you. Text the keyword KD to 68683. That's KD to 68683. Now listen, not only are we giving you tickets to check out Usher in Vegas, but we're also gonna hook you up with a one-night hotel stay and $100 for gas. We got you covered because we are 935 KDAY. Qué rico sería eso.
quiero beber, pero cuando te di hambre no podemos. Si tuviera una hembra como quiera yo te cogería a ti. No sé qué, como pero sé que estoy aquí. Te rodeo a estar en cuenta que me mamá de mí. Tú no lo sabes, te sé, marique.
¿Cómo se siente? ¿Cómo se siente?
Así que te sorprende y no eres tu delincuente. Tengo una hora de vuelta y que comente. Hoy es noche de cruel y yo voy pa' gente. En el camión ando moñado, tú sabes que estoy mo. Real está fuerte, ya no quiere estar mo. Ahora sé que tú tienes este ojo patrón. Me perro también, mía, mía, la corazoncito. En la noche, a la que hable, y te la bloquea.